Hi, and welcome to a bite-sized tutorial. In this one, we're having a look at how to create an isometric camera for a multiplayer game in Unity. So let's start by having a look at what we want to achieve. We want to use one camera to follow two or more players at the same time. And we also want the camera to zoom in and out to make sure that all the players are visible in the frame. I won't go through how to make the characters move, but there are plenty of tutorials online, and even one on this channel. Also worth mentioning is that I found these beautiful character models on the asset store, and I will leave a link to the pack down in the description. Now, in Unity, let's start with our camera. First, create an empty game object and call it camera, and make sure to reset the transform. Then, drag the main camera object into it to make it a child object, reset the transform, and set the position to negative 65 on the z-axis. And make sure the projection is set to orthographic. Worth a mention is that many of the values I'm using work for what I'm making here, but may need to be adjusted for your game. I'll set the size to 13 and decrease the near clipping planes a bit, to 0.1. I will also rotate the parent to 40 on the x-axis and 35 on the y-axis. Now, create a new script called camera controller. I like a fresh start, so I'll just clean this up a bit by removing the start and the update method for now. We can already declare some of the necessary variables up here. Private camera main camera. And let's just immediately assign our main camera to this in an awake method by typing main camera equals camera.main. We're going to need a list of targets, so let's add private list and within angle brackets transform and call it targets. Make sure you serialize the field and that you're including the system.collections.generic namespace up here in the top. Let's continue with private float edge buffer, which will work a bit as padding around our characters in the camera viewport. I'll start with a value of 4, but since we're serializing the field, we can easily change this in the inspector. These values are used to clamp the zoom value of the camera, and I'll go with 6 as the min size and 18 as the max size. And these values are used to smooth out the movement of the camera. I'll start with a value of 0.2 for the smooth time. And that's it for the initial variables, so let's move on to setting the starting position of our camera based on the player's positions. First, create a method to get the average position, a center point of our targets. Private vector3 getAverageposition. This expects to return a vector3 value, so let's add a local variable, var averageposition with a value of new vector3, and return it down here. I don't usually declare the types of my local variables, but if you prefer to, type vector3 here instead of var. We want this value to represent the midpoint of all of our targets, so let's add a simple for each loop. For each var target in targets. What we want to do in this method is to get all our targets' positions and add these to the average position variable here. Average position plus equals target.position. Now, below the for each loop, let's divide the average position by the number of targets. The last thing we want to do is to set the y value of the average position to transform.position.y. And that is how we get the average position, or the center point, of our characters. Let's now have a look at how we're getting the desired size of the camera that will fit all targets. Let's add a new method, private float getDesiredSize. Add a local variable called size with a value of 0.0f and return it down here. Add another one called desired local position and set its value to transform.inverseTransformPoint and pass in the getAverageposition method as the argument. InverseTransformPoint here is a method that converts a point from world space to local of the transform. Let's once again go through our targets with a for each loop. For each var target in targets. Let's convert the position of the current target to local space with var target local pos equals transform.inverse target point and pass in target.position as the argument. Now, let's calculate the distance between the desired position and the target in local space. Var desired pos to target equals target local pos minus desired local pause. Now we can update the size based on the distance along both the vertical and the horizontal axis. So size equals mathf.max, where the first argument is size, followed by mathf.abs with desired pause to target.y as its argument, and finally mathf.abs with desired pause to target.x as its argument, divided by mainCamera.aspect. mathf.abs is a method that returns the absolute value of a float, while mathf.max returns the maximum value among the arguments that we pass to it. To finish this up, we want to add a buffer to the size to make sure all the targets are visible. And to do that, we can return size plus edge buffer here. To also make sure that the value stays within our defined size restrictions, we can instead return mathf.clamp with size plus edge buffer as the first argument, followed by min size and finally max size. Now, in the start method, we can set the initial position and size of our camera. First, set the position of our camera object to the average position by typing transform.position equals getAverageposition. And we can set the size of our camera by typing mainCamera.orthographicSize equals getDesiredSize. Now, we need to see if this is working, so let's jump back into Unity. Make sure you've attached the script to the camera parent, and these values are for you to set to your liking. I'll assign my two player objects to the targets here and hit play. We can now see that the camera will immediately zoom in on the players and make sure that both of them fit in the frame, but it won't yet follow a moving character. And that's because we're only setting the values once in our start method, and they're never updating, so let's make some changes. Let's create a new method called setPosition that will simply set the position of the camera object that we can call in a lateUpdate method. In the setPosition method, we can simply type transform.position equals vector3.smoothDamp, where the first argument is the current position, so transform.position followed by getAverageposition, then ref velocity, and finally smoothTime. Let's again have a look in Unity to make sure this is working. Hit play and move the targets around. As you can see, the camera does follow the players, so it's all working. But as we're getting closer to the edge, we should be zooming out for both of them to fit. So let's jump back into our code. Just as we're setting the position here, we should have a method to set the size. Private void setSize, and call it from the lateUpdate method. This looks similar to what we just wrote, so let's type mainCamera.orthographicSize equals mathf.smoothDamp and make sure you're using the mathf library here instead of vector3. The first argument is mainCamera.orthographicSize, the second one is getDesiredSize, the third one is refZoomSpeed, and finally our smoothTime. I'm using the same value for smoothTime here, but if you feel like your game would benefit from having separate values for these, feel free to add another variable up here to smooth out the zoom value. And you know what? Let's jump back into Unity to test this out. As you can see, the camera is now zooming out when the players move away from each other, and back in when they're moving towards each other. Let's also look at the values in the inspector. As the players are walking away from each other, the size value never gets higher than 18. And as they're walking towards each other, the value stops at 6. And that's it. This should at least get you started on your multiplayer game and should work both locally as well as online, which I've tested with Fishnet. If you have any questions or feedback, please let me know. And as usual, the code can be found on my GitHub page, linked down in the description. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.